In this video, I'll show you how to download and install AutoSubs for free AI-powered subtitles on your computer. Welcome to this video. My name is David and I hope you're well wherever you are around the world. Now, AutoSubs comes as one but two versions in one, a standalone version and a DaVinci Resolve version. And the reason for the DaVinci Resolve is if you have the DaVinci Resolve free version. So if you're using DaVinci Resolve Studio, obviously you know it has the automatic subtitles locked in, but if you don't have the paid version, that is DaVinci Resolve Studio, you can use AutoSubs to automatically generate subtitles for your videos in DaVinci Resolve. But for this video, we're going to be downloading and installing AutoSubs. So I'll leave the link in the description below, and this is free. It's tomoroni.com AutoSubs. So I'll leave the link below, and it's AI-powered subtitles for DaVinci Resolve. You can generate and style subtitles directly on your editing timeline to match your brand. There's the option to download AutoSubs. I'll hold that for now, and then you can view it on GitHub. I'll click on this, view it on GitHub. And the reason for this is sometimes this particular version right here, you're not really sure which version it is you're downloading, but in the GitHub page, you're almost sure what you're downloading. So as you can see, as of 2 days ago, there was an update and all that. And the about of this is that it instantly generates AI-powered subtitles on your device. It works standalone or connects to DaVinci Resolve. You can scroll down to read more on everything. And what we have here right now is version 3. It has a new cleaner UI. It's faster and lighter, smarter models, better timing. The standalone mode, this one is now available. So you no longer require DaVinci Resolve. So the core capabilities is fast, accurate transcription in many languages, diarization, English translation, more languages coming soon, creator-friendly UI. So that's more or less of the basic. And the reason for this is the option to download and install. And if I've not yet mentioned it, it's available for Windows, Linux, and Mac. So that's a plus. Now, the reason why I mentioned that we come to this page is because of the releases right here. If I click on this, what happens is you can be able to see the full change log, kind of if that is something that you're interested in to see what happened right here, but you can go back. So that is the one reason why you may need to come to this particular page instead of just downloading it from here. So when you're here, you can see what is available, the assets, or if you actually want a specific version of the download file available. So that is something that you can actually work with, and you can see in 307, fix the critical issue with Resolve track selection, robust audio decoding and details and all that. So you can see what you're working with. And also, if you wanted to download older versions, like version 2 and all that, that were specifically for DaVinci Resolve, then this is what you may want to do. You can even go to page 4, where we have AutoSubs version 1.0 as of May 16, 2023. So, and obviously click on this, you'll be able to see the assets, the source code and all that. But we want page 1, and this is where we are going to go with, I'm on Windows, I'm going to go with this one. Click on it, and it's going to automatically download on my computer, super, super fast, a 64 MB file. So that's the first step, the downloading. But the backstory is why you may need to actually come to the releases page to get to understand what went on in the background. But that's downloaded. I'll just click on this and navigate to the folder with AutoSubs downloaded, and it's right there. I can just right click on it and run as an administrator. Yes, I want to allow this program to make changes, and I can just minimize everything else right here and then follow the on-screen prompts to install. Click on next, and then where I want to install it. And then once you click on next, it's going to extract AutoSubs, FFmpeg, and all the other things involved in creating AutoSubs. So there we go, it's completed. I'll click on next. So AutoSubs setup. AutoSubs was successfully installed. To use AutoSubs in DaVinci Resolve for this case, open DaVinci Resolve, navigate to Workspace, scripts in the top menu, select AutoSubs, and enjoy your new subtitles. Click on OK. So we have it, and we can click on finish. Now let's search for it, AutoSubs, and just open it up. And once we do that, you'll see the welcome page is going to be a setup page. So the setup page is right here. and there's previous, next, and welcome to AutoSubs. Let's set your preferences. It will only take a minute. So I'll click on next and choose your mode. Are you using it with DaVinci Resolve or as a standalone? Let's assume it's a standalone for this. Click on that, standalone, transcribe files. You can drag and drop and then click on next. The input language, depending on if you know, I'll just leave it as default auto. Click on next. And then you can choose the AI model here. So for example, the base is more or less what I would kind of go with. Is a really good one. It's reliable for everyday transcription with good speed and accuracy. And as you actually navigate through the different modes, you can see what each model is good at. So let's just go with the base, then click on next, and then a subtitle line rule. So for example, if you're looking for one line, by default, it's one line, 34 characters, split on punctuation. You can click on this gear icon and change maybe to 37. I'd go with 37 and then go with a line count of 2. That is what I'd go with. Our text case is normal. Okay, I'll leave everything as it is. But if you wanted to remove punctuation, you can do that. If you wanted to censor sensitive words, you can also do that, which is really, really important. Click on next, and then the setup is complete. I'll click on finish. And from here, you now have everything set up. Now, there's only one step I do believe is remaining. This particular AI speech transcription model is not yet downloaded. So what I'm going to do is maximize my screen here and then just bring in a file. Let's say just bring in a short file right there. It's added. You can see it here. And because we've already made the settings here, all I need to do now is just come down and you can see some experimental things. Dynamic time mapping, improved subtitle word alignment, which is really awesome. You can turn it on. GPU acceleration, if your laptop or computer has a graphics processing unit, that is important. And also the other text formatting rules we set are right there. So everything is ready for us to go. What I'm going to do is now click on start transcription. It's going to download the base model because we've not used it before. So it's going to download the base model. And once it's done downloading, it's going to automatically transcribe our subtitle into our video into subtitles on this other side. So the base model is almost done downloading, and then the transcription process is going to begin. And because that's a short video, it's already done. So it's super fast right here, and you can see that right here. So you can make changes, you can make edits. For example, I know this word needs to be used the descripts right there. Remove this word. I actually want to remove this one. Save changes, and you can see the changes in real time right there. So if you'd like to export, just click on export either as an SRT or as a JSON file. Download SRT and then set it where you want it to be. And that's it for that particular video. If you're using Resolve, you'll need to set it and ensure it's connected, but I'll show you that in a future video. That's it for this video, and that is how you can download and install and run AutoSubs for free AI-powered subtitles on your computer. That's it for this video. I hope it's of value to you. Thanks for watching.